And we are here! Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and however you would like to address yourself as. Welcome to the third episode of Streamwalking. Yeah, indeed, let's see what happens, because I have just as much of a clue as you guys. Like, as always, I'm going in completely blind. Now, I don't know about you guys, but for those of you living in the Netherlands, most of the viewers here live in the Netherlands right now. I hope that you guys were not as stupid as I was today in going out for a cycling trip, because I did. And the wind was not my friend. It was, well, or, I mean, if the wind is in your face and in your everything, does it, is it your friend then, or is it your enemy? I'm not sure. Maybe it actually really wanted to be friends and I just wasn't open to it. I don't know. But it was an intense day. So, short said, I am a bit tired. And tired is not bad at all. I mean, I'm very excited to write, yeah, Gerko, that's a good point. After trip, it can indeed be your friend. Yes, very much so. Yes, well, the answer is always blowing in the wind. I mean, God damn it, Eric, you've already earned like one... Okay, I'm just gonna say this right now. Editor Bram, of course, Editor Bram is here again. Say hi, Editor Bram, everyone in the chat. Editor Bram, give Eric two yellow cards already, because he also made a comment in advance saying... I made a comment saying that that I was making sure nothing was burning down here before I went live on camera with you guys. And then Eric said, if things burn down there, I think you should see a doctor and not go streaming. Well, the thing is, Eric, things burn when I stream. I'm very ashamed of that joke, but at the same time, considering my fandom of Frank Zappa, it checks out. Check out Joe's Garage if you have no idea what I'm talking about. I'm legitimately open for any ideas right now, because the first time, which is now 4 weeks ago, time goes fast, time is weird. 4 weeks ago, we did a grindcore song with jazzy parts. And last week, or 2 weeks ago, we did a synth pop song with a metal ending, a lot of kitten meows, and basically a lot of randomness. There's a dubstep drum fill in the backlog, yeah? Well, there's one thing in the backlog, because Marcel asked me last time if I could add steel drums, and I promised him steel drums. And I actually have, I actually put some time into it to find steel drums. So I have a really crappy steel drum sound now, which we can use. And it would be really funny to implement that somewhere. I'm open for any ideas. So yeah, chat, go nuts. Doom Polka! Jesus. Oh my god, Doom Polka. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Doom Polka. Polka tends to be mostly like clarinets and like that's like polka. There's no way in hell I can turn that into doom. Can I? This is already the worst idea ever. Okay, what would be a good lyric for a doom polka song? I mean, it could be about anything really. You could do so many things with that. Lyrics for doom polka. I mean, doom is like depression. Depression, sadness. I'm just gonna write down some words. So here, it's like depression, sadness, and I don't know, loneliness. All those things that you want to talk about at a children's party. The theme of feeling awkward at a party, that's a good starting point. And wind in your face when on your bike. Galadriel just came up with the wind in your face when on your bike. I mean, that's very topical. The chat is exploding here on Twitch. Other feelings of doom and gloom, Eric says. Buying cheap toilet paper that claims to be 2-ply, but it's so thin that it's really just 0.75-ply. And your hands were covered in poop. Barefoot on Lego. Actually, guys, I think that the whole... There's like a whole bunch of things. Cycling against the wind, right? Cycling against the wind. Eric goes stepping barefoot on Lego. Yannicka says being on a party you don't want to be at. Don't want to be at than anticipated. Like all this stuff, this just sounds like the shittiest day. This literally just sounds like a shit day. And a shitty day could be really good for Doom Polka. Like, it's depressing and it's angry and it's stupid. But at the same time, it's like, it's still polka. Let's just quickly finish up the synopsis for the song here. Synopsis. Cycling against the wind to a party you don't want to be at. Once at the party, you get explosive diarrhea. I would say this is a pretty realistic storyline, even. This is something that could... This could happen to you. Be aware. Be very, very careful, because this could happen to you. I'm just going to put on the magic ears, because we're going to start making some music in a bit. Here we go. Everything that I wrote down here is going to be included. Like, you know, it could be two things. I mean, I'm just thinking out loud here. It could be that I'm doing doom metal and I just put a bunch of polka instruments in there, but I think that's kind of cheap. You know what I mean? It's like I could just write a doom riff and put a clarinet on top and we're done. That doesn't really sound like something I would want to be into. So what I want to do is write something that sounds polka-like and then just slow it the fuck down. So for a polka drum kit,
I'm a very manly man. That was very, very deep voice.
I'll just start with this for now, because I don't necessarily feel like building a complete drum kit, and I feel that getting the musical part of this in order is going to be hard enough as it is. I think this could work. It kind of reminds me of the Schlager Germany kind of vibe. Like that kind of drum. That's the kind of drum that you want to go for when you're doing something polka-ish, I believe. And now it sounds like I'm very knowledgeable about polka, and actually I'm not. I think my knowledge, I legit think that my knowledge of polka literally stems from cartoons in which I heard polka, or like, yodeladdy, yodeladdy, yodeladdy stuff, you know, like that's my knowledge of polka. I'm gonna make the drums more interesting later, but I first just wanted to have a rhythm to work with. Now, let's think here. If I'm gonna go for that, do I have a tuba? Because I believe I did. I just gotta double check. I'm kind of also expecting a lot of fart jokes every time I'm talking about tuba, because for me, one of the standard comments I make when someone rips out a fart is like, hey, someone's practicing tuba. You know, it just kind of happens. Joey, for those of you on YouTube who are not reading this, you're like, why don't you just make it a three-quart waltz? Boom, bop, bop, boom, bop, bop, boom, bop, bop, boom, bop, bop. And that actually would solve so much. Yeah, a bit carnivalish, indeed. Like, Gerko goes, ah yeah, a bit carnivalish. I think that might actually be the golden thing to go for here. Like, Hans just said something about using an offbeat measure. I think I might be able to put like a five, because this is 3/4. I could put a 5/4 in there. Yes, Hans. Actually, I said clarinet, because for me, I actually love clarinet as an instrument, but when I'm thinking of polka, I tend to think of accordions and clarinets. You know, like that kind of stuff. I know that on the first time I get some complaints saying people like, it was a bit loud, you know, like the speakers were clipping, and I don't want that, so I'm just gonna put a very simple mastering filter on top, you know, because it's almost like I'm learning from my mistakes. Almost. Also, for those of you who are interested, this is the BBC Symphonic Orchestra. I got the full version here from Spitfire Audio. This is a ridiculously complex library of sounds, which it has almost everything. It's just that I don't really write as much with tubas and trombones and such. So for me, this is relatively new, but I think I'll be able to make it work. How else can you convey explosive diarrhea in a musical sense? Marcel asks in the chat. How else can you, convey it? I don't know. We need to have at least one tuba, like, at a certain point, there needs to be a break with, like, at least four notes being played at the same time discordantly to underline that, I think. That should be in there somewhere. Joey on Twitch just said that instead of Looney Tunes, we're going for Doomy Tunes. That's what he just asked. And I think that is a pretty accurate description. Brown note. Yeah, we're going to hit the brown note tonight. That's the idea. And Hans just said I should add a bassoon for the fart sound. So that's exactly what I'm doing right now. Let me load up a bassoon. So if I play this. Okay, let's add this underneath. If I can add this underneath the actual tuba.
Yeah.
we got ourselves something that sounds cartoony and somewhat evil. It's like the intro music to the villain. You know what I mean? Like the villain's lair or something. Yes, here's where I concoct all my evil schemes! And then obviously those evil schemes never happen because villains in cartoons are supposed to lose. I am legitimately writing a cartoon song with a diarrhea part and a Lego scream. Thank you, Galadriel. What happened to my life that I ended up in this place? Where did I go wrong? Or where did I go right? Am I right? If there's anything I've learned from the chat, according to Eric, is that I've learned that the chat is evil and that the chat is inevitable. Fear us. I'm just gonna start in 3/4. 3/4. But boom pa pa, boom pa pa, boom pa pa, boom pa pa, boom pa pa. And then the last one, I think we're gonna do the last one in 5/4. And I mean, knowing me, it starts out like this, and at the end we're still gonna add some metal guitars because at the end of the song it's just annoying and you wanna go home and you just have that explosive diarrhea and you're like, fuck my life and all the choices that I've made leading up to this point. Oh wow. Okay, so there's some interesting things happening in the chat here on Twitch for those of you watching on YouTube right now. Let me just read this out loud. First of all, oh, for the Lego scream, get your friend Wilhelm in. That is actually a badly imitated Wilhelm. I'm not sure if I can do it. It's like, it's something like that, right? It's like that high scream. This is gonna be so stupid to write lyrics for. Well, in a way it is. Yeah, actually, Yonika on YouTube said that the melody kind of reminds her of the Tetris theme. No, actually, the Tetris reference isn't that weird because in a lot of classical music, this is like a bit of a regular interval kind of thing. It's an interval on, I'm not entirely sure what the official name for it is, but indeed, this is something you hear in a lot of Russian music as well, Russian classical music as well. So that's not even that far off, really, and especially when we start adding the chords, then it'll definitely start sounding like a bit of a Russian thing. The Russian composers were good at a few things. That was depression, drinking way too much, and sorrow. Just sorrow. All of they just had a legitimate claim on that, I would say. Once again, copy paste the accordion part because I think a lot of the chords are actually similar. Eh, I was wrong. I'm an idiot. It was Joey who says, "Why do they always send the poo?" For those of you who know the song BYOB, what the hell is that about? That is, yeah, that's the thing. Not gonna do that. You did get yourself a yellow card out of this. Enjoy. Enjoy your yellow card. It's good for your soul, I guess. And I think in the second pre-chorus, instead of that ridiculous da 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 da, that should just be, there should just be like this fart noise and a little break. And then the song picks up again. I want to have a ding or something in there, and I think that it was Drumdos who came up with the beautiful idea of adding in a cowbell. Exactly, cowbell instead of the ding, because the ding would be like the classical music thing to put like to go for that little break and go for. But that would be cliche, so. I would prefer, instead of the ding, we're gonna go for the cowbell. Picking cowbells is a very serious matter. If you're not sure about what cowbell to pick, please consult your physicist. Your physicist will tell you which cowbell will stick right up your. No. Oh, I like that one. This actually might work. C'est le grand artiste. C'est le grand artiste poupie. That's what this is. Joey just scored another yellow card by saying, this is better than art. It's fart. If that doesn't secure your place in heaven, I don't know what does. And of course, we still need to add some steel drums somewhere. Because Marcel wanted steel drums. Isn't that right, Marcel? Steel drums. Exactly. Team steel drums. And I actually found out that the onboard sound system of Cubase here...
This is never gonna work.
This is never gonna work. That's a good point that Joey is making in the chat here on Twitch. Parties that we don't want to go to often have steel drums. Eric... There, you've got enough yellow cards to plaster your wall, but here's another one. When I hear steel drums, I think of someone robbing a music store. Steel drum. Oh god. Okay, yeah, this is why you're my admin and why you're my mod. I know. So, I have a Wilhelm scream. Let's see how loud this is. It's probably really fucking loud, so let me just... Perfection. Here we go. We gotta make this metal near the end, right? Because it's frustrating. So the ending should just be like doom metal. You know, it should just be that riff. And then just gradual annoyance building up as you want to leave that party and never return there. And I don't know, move to Ethiopia or something. And we get our point across relatively concisely. We can add the doom now. Because what I want to do is actually get rid of everything. Now we have this whole polka setup. And I'm just going to mute it real quick. I'm going to ruin this. This is also going to be problematic because it's a drop A. So, but my guitar actually is in drop A. So I'll be able to go all the way down to the lowest point there. The doom suggestion here isn't even that bad of an idea, to just drop the tempo. Oh my god. Well, yeah, that's... The drum beat definitely needs to be doomier. Less System of a Down, more depressing doom metal. Like, we can just instantly go doom really, really badly. But first, obviously, we need to bring this little bastard. Yes, Eric, indeed, for those of you who like Monty Python, I have already been dubbed Tom Two Studios DeWitt. And for those of you who don't get that reference, shame on you. You should watch more Monty Python show as opposed to just the movies. And yes, Gerko, playing slow is actually hard, believe it or not. At least I think it is. It's easier to play faster for me. But obviously, most riffs I tend to rehearse a bit more. And now I am, well, unrehearsed just doing this on a limb. So there you go. Joey makes a good point. Playing slow is hard because you're waiting for the next note to hit and then you miss it. That's actually a legit problem. Ta, ta, ta. The guitar sound you're hearing right now is not the one I'm recording. I'm recording it reamped so we can actually make a proper doomy guitar sound for this in a bit. But I just first want to record the riffs like this so that I have it tight on the click and that I know what I'm doing. Ding, ding. I have no idea what's going on regarding the Family Guy references in the chat, but I approve of Family Guy references, so keep them coming. There was talk about diahrrea, so it's... Joey just went, we're talking about diahrrea, so this is more like sheet metal.
It's about poop!
And also, another trick that I will repeat until the end of time, and that is, always play more than you actually need to record. This goes for every instrument. So the moment you need to play four bars, always play five. So you can make a good clean cut at the end of the fourth one, and it'll sound like a seamless transition if you put something else after it. I see Alex talking about Tokyo, which is one of my life goals to ever visit Japan, because I've never been to Japan. And I'm actually working on a very special song right now regarding a Japanese goddess. I want to release it later this month, and it's going to be a really cool art project. I found an artist from Australia who's doing some work on that. Basically, it's going to be a trip. It's basically Japanese folk meets my kind of prog metal that I'm working on right now. I'm even talking and singing some Japanese on that very track. So that's definitely something that's going to be in there. Okay, we're going to make a guitar sound real quick. Oh shit. This could be me, but I actually kind of already like how it sounds out of the box, which is not what I thought would happen. And then what I tend to do with the guitars, it's also a trick that I showed you guys before, is make a little group for it. A little rhythm guitar group. And that's also because I'm a lazy fuck, and it's really nice to have all your guitars in one place so you can just turn everything softer or louder, depending on a specific part, and you know that it's influencing everything. An important message for those of you producing in Cubase: work with group tracks. It'll make your life a lot easier. Trust me on this. I'm gonna go for the fart transition and then see how the metal kicks in. Oh, well. Well, that went doom all of a sudden, didn't it? Also, I'm gonna name it properly, see, doom with the umlauts, because obviously it's metal and metal needs umlauts. So I think by now we've got a we've got a sound that switches quite radically. We got this this cartoony thingy going on here. We're gonna go full doom. Might as well add a fucking church organ. The reason why I'm asking Sebastian for all of you is Sebastian obviously works for me with Layered Reality Productions, but he is also my resident doom head, and he knows all about all these incredibly dramatic bands that make you want to kill yourself, and then he's there like, yee, you know, happily listening to it. The cool part is I actually have one which I want to show you guys because I think you'll dig this. This one is called the Leeds Town Hall Organ, and listen to this. It's like, this is the sweet one, but once you do this, like, that's a legit dramatic organ. You know, that's a legit dramatic sound. And yes, a high-tapping guitar solo on top would be great, but it's already 9:15, and we're gonna do this till 10, so we really gotta start working on the vocals and the lyrics. Eric, you almost a rather this like the official British title would be a rather fecal 24 hours. Like an American would just be like a shit day. A rather fecal 24 hours. That's what it could be. It could be so much. So I think the first part should be. I don't wanna go to this party right now. I don't feel social at all. Like something along those lines. Really, I really want to channel my inner Herman van Veen, Jacques Brel kind of vibe here.
I don't wanna go to this party right now. I don't really feel social at all. Cycling up against this hill and against all this wind feels like pedaling up to a wall.
So let's not overdo it. I wish I stayed home with my books and cat. Relatable, right? Could also be dog, but, you know, I'm a cat person, so there we go.
I wish I stayed home with my books and my cat and everything I'd like to surround myself with every time.
Ugh! Cats and all my stuff. And not these people that I... And not these people and their steel drums.
Home with my books and my cat and all my stuff and not these people with their steel drums.
That actually fits. It actually fits. It actually fits.
I don't want to be at a party with steel drums. This is my Serge Tankian System of a Down influence. There you go.
With my books and my cat and all my stuff and then these people and their steel drums. So they offered me some snacks and some drinks at the start. And my stomach's rumbling like something bad. I really feel my bowels explode right here on the spot. Was it in the pie that I had?
Like, I'm just listening to this, I'm like, it needs... Is this the return? Is this the return of the Muppet Choir?
Makes rumbling like something.
Ah-ha!
I really feel my bowels explode right here.
We wish we had more time, but unfortunately we don't have steel drums or dubstep breaks. Maybe next time.
Diarrhea running down my legs. Jesus, who put Lego here?
Will Tom ever include the steel drums in his songs? What will be the next exciting song? Tune in next time to Streamwalking.
There you go, then the whole Dragon Ball Z theme starts playing.
I didn't want to be at this very party.
Oh, the horror, oh, the pain. It's like... It's like a chocolate rain. Oh my god.
A chocolate rain!
I'm gonna go full drama, and I'm gonna add screams and growls to this as well. For those of you who lived on the internet in the early days, the days of old, chocolate rain!
Didn't want to be at this party, everything went wrong today. I can shit at someone else's place. How the horror,
how the pain, it's like chocolate rain.
Chocolate rain!
Now, let's add some to it. And I'm gonna do that relatively soft, because it's just gonna be an effect in the background.
Jesus, who put Lego here?
I didn't want to be at this party. Everything went wrong today. I get shit at someone else's place.
Let's listen to the song together once from the start. Here we go.
I don't wanna go to this party right now. I don't really feel social at all. Cycling up against this hill and against all this wind. Feels like pedaling. Rumbling like something bad. I really feel my bowels explode.
I think we got ourselves a very dramatic song about getting diarrhea at a party and hating cycling against the wind and everything. I expected that it was going to be fun, but diarrhea is a new low. Like, next time we really get to see if we can find something, something with a bit more class. Then again, who am I kidding? Who am I kidding? This is hilarious. I love it. I think we all did it. We made a very shitty song together. I'm very proud of you guys. But seriously, though, thank you guys so much for being here and being a part of this, you know, being a part of this beautiful and fun experience once again. My only call to action, which I do at the end of every show, is this. If you like what I do and if you want to support what I do besides watching this show, you're like, hey, I like this kind of stuff and I really want to be involved in this, check out the website that I just posted in there, tdwmusic.com. You can find a web store there where you can also buy my music, my records, etc. And obviously that's very much appreciated if you do. That's my more serious music, which is less about diarrhea and more about existential crises explored in 20-minute songs. Which is, of course, a very apt description of what I do. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think there's much else to add. Tomorrow night, the song is going live. Thank you all so much for being in the chat. I'm going to close this off now. So if there's anything else you want to say near the end, then please do so now or remain silent. Good night, everyone. I hope you will have a proper stool after this. I hope you'll be able to poop the mightiest of poops and that you'll feel perfectly happy doing that. Because, you know, a good poop is something you wish upon everybody. There you go. Have a good one. Love you all. Stay safe. And let's see each other again in 2 weeks, which is the 22nd of February. Can't wait to see you all there. All right. Have a good one, guys. Later.